I'm Forrest, Forrest Gump.
Oh, hello.
Do you have an appointment here today, too?
Yes, I do.
I'm hoping to get a job mowing the lawn here. I used to mow the grass back in Greenbow, Alabama, at the college. That's where I'm from. I'm supposed to meet with Miss Lisa at 1 o'clock with Cornerstone to talk about the job.
That's nice.
Do you want a chocolate?
No, thank you.
I could eat about 1.5 million of these. My mama always said life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. I bet those are comfortable shoes. My mama always said you could tell a lot about a person by the shoes they wear, where they're going, where they've been. I bet you could walk all day in those shoes and not feel a thing.
My feet hurt.
I've worn lots of shoes. I bet if I think real hard, I can remember my first pair of shoes. Mama said they'd take me anywhere. They were my magic shoes. Mama always knew what to say to make me feel better. I sure do miss my mama. It seems like only yesterday when I last saw her.
Hi, Forrest.
What's the matter, Mama?
I'm dying, Forrest. Come on in and sit down over here.
Why are you dying, Mama?
It's just my time. It's just my time. Now don't you be afraid, sweetheart. Dying's just a part of life. Something we're all destined to do. I didn't know it, but I was destined to be your mama, and I did the best I could do.
You did good, Mama.
Well, I happen to believe that you make your own destiny, and you have to do the best with what God gave you.
What's my destiny, Mama?
You're going to have to figure it out for yourself. Life is like a box of chocolates for us. You never know what you're going to get.
Mama always had a way of explaining things so I could understand them.
I'll miss you, Forrest.
She had gotten the cancer and died on a Tuesday. I bought her hat with little yellow flowers on it. That's why I wear this pink pin, to remind me of her every day. That's all I have to really say about that. Now, even though I went to college and played lots of football and was an All-American and a war hero and a professional ping pong player and a shrimp boat captain and a gazillionaire and a cross-country runner, it just never made me, you know, truly happy. Not until the day I married my best friend and my true love, my Jimmy. Jimmy was like peas and carrots. We weren't married very long, though, because she had gotten sick and had gone up to heaven with Mama and Bubba. Jenny did give me a wonderful gift, though, before she left, my little son, Forrest.
I'm so sorry to hear about your wife. Where's your little boy now?
He's back home in Greenbow with my friend Lieutenant Dan and his fiance till I get back. I think about Jenny all the time. I really do miss her.
Hey.
Hey.
Forrest, were you scared in Vietnam?
Yes. Well, I don't know. Sometimes it would stop raining long enough for the stars to come out. And then it was nice. It was like just before the sun goes to bed down on the bayou. There's all these million sparkles on the water. Or like that mountain lake. It was so clear, Jenny. It looked like two skies, one on top of the other. And then in the desert, when the sun comes up, I couldn't tell where heaven stopped and the earth began. It was so beautiful.
I wish I could have been there with you.
You were.
Forrest, I want to apologize for the way I treated you all those years. I was messed up, and I'm sorry for all that I put you through.
I know you never meant to hurt me, Jenny.
I love you.
You died on a Saturday morning, I had you placed here under our tree.
And I had that house of your father's bulldozed to the ground. Mama always said that dying was a part of life. I sure wish it wasn't. Little Forrest, he's doing just fine. About to start school again soon.
To my mother, a mother bird sat on her egg.
I make his breakfast, lunch, and dinner every day. Make sure he combs his hair and brushes his teeth every day. Teaching him to play ping pong.
Okay, Forrest, your turn.
Oh! He's really good. And we fish a lot. And every night we read a book. So smart, Jenny. You'd be so proud. I am. He wrote you this letter and says, I can't read it. I'm not supposed to, so I'll just leave it here for you. Jenny, I don't know if Mama was right or if it was Lieutenant Dan. We all have a destiny, or if we're all just floating accidental-like on a breeze. But I think maybe it's both. Maybe both is happening at the same time. I miss you, Jenny. If there's anything you need, I won't be far away.
Mr. Gump! Mr. Gump!
Oh, that's me. But it sure was nice talking to you.
And you as well. Best of luck to you.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi.
I brought you some chocolates.
Why, that was very sweet of you.
I ate some.
Why don't you sit down and have a seat and tell me about yourself?
Okay. My name's Forrest Gump. People call me Forrest Gump.